Hi, my name is Stacey Kulesza. I'm an associate professor of civil engineering at Texas State University. When I think about why I wanted to become a civil engineer, it's because, primarily because most of my family are civil engineers, but that gave me the opportunity to learn a lot about it as I was growing up. So, for example, I remember when I was going to soccer practice and my mom said, "My friend designed that bridge. That's a part of civil engineering. The roads we were driving on to go there, that's a part of civil engineering." All of these things are part of our infrastructure. Infrastructure is kind of a vague word, but it's a word we use a lot, and it describes a system that is used to meet your everyday needs. So in civil engineering, these are roads, bridges, water, wastewater, dams, levees, all of that is part of civil engineering, which makes my field really, really diverse. So when you become a civil engineer, you get to learn about every aspect is about it, as well as each individual component. Actually, we have 6 different types of civil engineers that you can be. You can be in geotechnical, water resources, environmental, structural, transportation, or materials. And at Texas State, we're going to teach you about all of those different programs. What's unique about our program is we focus on technology-enhanced infrastructure. So there's that word infrastructure again. When we build something, we don't want to just leave it there and just hope it does what I want it to do. We're going to have to monitor it over time. We're going to have to figure out when it needs repair or just how it's behaving. This is very much the state of the practice, but something that we don't often teach civil engineering students, but we do at Texas State. So if you're here, in addition to taking your normal civil engineering courses that you would take at most other programs, you'll also take a course just in technology-enhanced infrastructure. You'll take a course in circuits, because that's how we design sensors. You'll take a course in programming, so that you can understand how to process your data. And every course we have also has a component where we're teaching about the data that you're collecting, that you will be when you have a job, in order to understand how our infrastructure is behaving over time and how well it's performing. Another reason why I really like civil engineering is because of the career opportunities you will have. Because it's in service of everyday life, we're going to always need a civil engineer, because you're going to always need to go to work to have access to clean drinking water. The career opportunities are endless, because you can work, as within most engineering, in the public sector, the private sector, and that means going in industry, where you're going to work for a design firm, or in the public sector, working for government entities. And as a civil engineer, we need government agencies in the capital, like in Austin. But if you're from a small town, there's going to be a government civil engineer that works in that town. So you could also live in a small town. If you work for a contractor, for example, which is a type of industry, being a part of industry, you can have jobs where you stay in one area your whole life if you want to do that. And you can have a job where you travel every week if you want to do that. And you can have a job where you work internationally if you want to do that. So really, no matter what type of career you want to have, you can do that as a civil engineer. Similar to all fields of engineering, you could also graduate and go to law school. You could go to medical school. So you're really not limited to this career path. Again, hopefully this appeals to you. If this is something that really speaks to you and what you think you might want to do as your next steps at Texas State, please look at our website, enroll in our courses, and I hope to see you. You'll see me around your junior year. That's when you get to my classes.